In the last video, I said very mysteriously that sometimes there is a difference in our ordering with the from and the join clauses. In addition, I also mentioned very mysteriously that there are several different kinds of joins available to us. So in this video, we're going to explore these two bullet points a little bit more. Okay, so here's how we're going to do it. We're going to try to write out another join statement. Our initial attempt at this statement is going to be very simple, very easy, and it's going to be, well, correct. But I'm going to then make a very small change to one of our tables. We're going to add in one record, and then all of a sudden, the query is not going to do exactly what we expect anymore. So here's the goal. I want to show each photo's URL and the username of the poster. And very critically, we must show every single photo, no matter what. No matter how many photos there are in the database, no matter what state or form they are in, we must show every single photo. That's our goal. All right, so if we imagine how we would do this, well, we've been through this process several times now. We could start off with photos. We would imagine this new temporary table of something like photos with users. We would then walk through every one of these user IDs, and for each one, we would take a look at our users table and link up the appropriate user. So there's user with ID 3, and then user with ID 1. And then in our case, we don't really care about any of the columns inside of here except for URL and username. So we would delete everything else, and that's it. Everything would work. So let's go write out this query very quickly. Back over here. Let me just refresh really quickly. And we'll do a select URL and username from photos. We'll then join in our users table on users.id, and we want to find some record or row out of the photos table with a user ID equivalent or equal to users.id. So we're going to put in here photos.userid. So let's run that. And sure enough, well, we get the correct result. This is a list of all 20 photos, and we see each photo's URL and each username as well. Now, the key critical thing I want you to remember here is that when we executed this join, every single photo had a user ID value that linked up perfectly with our list of users. So I'm now going to throw a little wrench in this. We're going to insert another row into our photos table, and it's going to break this query slightly. Now the query is still going to run, but it's not going to fulfill our original goal anymore. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to add in a new photo with maybe a URL of banner.jpg and a user ID value of null. That's the trick right there. We're going to put in a value of null. A value of null means no user owns this record. No user posted this photo. Now, in a real photo sharing application, would this ever occur? Well, possibly. It's entirely possible. Maybe there are some company-owned photos, like the actual app operator put up some number of photos that every single application needs to show for some reason. Who knows? It's entirely possible. Now, your initial concern here, you might say, well, Steven, didn't we put on that on-delete cascade restriction? We did, but that's talking about deletion of some associated record. In this case, we're going to create a photo with no associated user whatsoever. That is not going to violate any constraint inside of our database. We can freely insert photos that don't reference a user ID. The only problem comes if we start to try to delete a user that still has a photo referencing it. So let's go back over and try to create a new photo, and we're going to make sure we give it a user ID value of null. Okay, so back over here, I'm going to comment out our existing query by selecting all of it and then hitting Command/, or alternatively, you could just delete it and then copy paste it from the query history over here a little bit later on, totally up to you. I'm then going to insert into photos, and I'm only going to provide a value of URL and user ID. We'll then designate the values that we are going to provide. So I'll put in here something like banner.jpg and null. I'll then go ahead and run this. Okay, looks like it was successful. So I'm now going to delete that insert statement. I'm then going to uncomment what we had before. And then I'm going to run this query again. But before I do, remember one of our big restrictions here, or the big purposes of this query, was to say we had to show every photo URL, no matter what. If it's inside of our database, it must be listed in the output. Okay, so with that in mind, let's now click on Run. it looks like we still get a result, but I want you to scroll through here now. Scroll through here, and you're going to notice something interesting. We do not see anything related to that photo that we just added. We only see the original 20 photos, and we see nothing else inside of here. Now, is that relevant? Well, without a doubt, it's not satisfying the goal of our query anymore. We are not listing out all photos. We are now only listing photos that are somehow related to a user inside of our database. So we're not getting all photos, only photos related to a user. Is this a problem? Again, yes, because it doesn't fulfill the original goal of our query. We might be trying to pull some information about every photo to get some idea of how many photos total there are, or maybe the total storage size of all photos inside of our database. It's always critical to make sure that we fulfill each query that we're trying to answer exactly. And right now, we aren't because we're not listing all photos. So how are we going to solve this? How can we make sure to somehow join photos with users, but still somehow list out that photo right there? And what's more, why is that photo not being listed out at all? Well, let's take a pause right here and then try to answer some of these questions in the next video.